We will talk about the goal of how facilitation is done and what can we do to improve our facilitation skills. So based on whatever we have done, thank you all of you who played a role here, especially Karan. Like it was nice learning. So whatever we do, whatever surgery we do of your conversations, don't take it personally. It is just a sample case. That is just we used it to create some interaction and discussion. So it has nothing to do with how these guys did here. It's more to do with what do we learn and how do we take it forward. So they just helped us to uncover what is facilitation. So based on your improvement as well as went well, we are trying to figure out two things. One is, what is the role of a facilitator? That's the one thing you can figure it out here. And so you write it role of a facilitator here using a pen directly. And then we talk about how to possibly we can organize a meeting. So these are the two things we will try to extract from our experience of that 10-minute simulation and see how it went. So here you write role of a facilitator, and here you write Now, in agile world, we have so many meetings. You have a daily stand-up, you have a sprint review, retrospective, planning, and many release planning, though they are not scrum meeting, but you end up doing release planning. If you go to Saket, a few more meetings get added, scrum of scrum, ABC design discussions, they are full of meetings. And traditionally, since we started project management and thing, meetings are known for wastage of time. Many of you might have observed, you go to a meeting, it really sucks. You sit there, nothing moves, few people keep talking, you keep sitting, and it was always a problem. There was always a problem of documentation, there was always a problem of unproductive meeting. These problems were always there. Now, with Agile coming in, we need to solve this problem more proactively. Else, we may end up into a situation that we do have a lot of meetings, but if the meetings are not productive, we may end up wasting good amount of time. Does it relate to you? Because most of you have done agile, non-agile, all types of development, and you can relate to many times. Once you become manager, some days you enter in the office, and by the time it becomes 6 o'clock, you are sitting in some of the meetings. Yeah, if the whole day is gone and you are moving from one meeting to another meeting, and finally you realize 50-60% of the meeting doesn't relate to the project you are working on. They are like something waste of at least direct waste of time, maybe indirectly they give you some benefits. So that is why the facilitator role start becoming popular. Or I'm talking about a role. Most of the project managers were playing that role when they were facilitating the meeting. In today's world, most of the scrum masters end up playing that role when they facilitate the meeting. Anybody who is facilitating a discussion which may be looking and towards the design decisions, which might be evaluating multiple options, which might be deciding how do we take forward our development process, requires a facilitation. So we need to have some skills to achieve those facilitation work better. In your view, what are the skills or a role of a facilitator in order to make these meetings better? So we have seen, you have a lot of improvement areas. What is the role of a facilitator?
Objective. You need to be clear with the objective of the particular meeting.
So he need to drive the productive discussion. So I would say that he need to put a structure. So objective would be a specific thing. So idea is that you need to put a structure.
What is the outcome required from the meeting? That is the first thing.
Okay. So the facilitator should have a skill to organize a meeting. So organize a meeting may involve setting up the agenda, setting up the outcome, setting up the process, setting up the duration, and finally giving that process to the people so that they can drive something. So a facilitator, the role of a facilitator to facilitate the meeting. And how do we facilitate the meeting? Put a structure for meeting. So it's like you put up a structure so people can get into the content of it. What else? So it covers many parts, rather than only this goal setting. It covers
moderation.
He should be doing moderation. So he should allow a group discussion. So he should promote sharing of ideas. So that is something he should do. Moderation. So if he does a good moderation, the sharing of ideas can be achieved. So he should be a good moderator, or he may use some structure which moderates the stuff. What else?
Time box.
So structure, kind of time box.
Yeah.
Structure covers more of all those things. But again, talk about time box, role, ground rules. Ground rule for a meeting. So he may also set up a ground rule. Rule for a meeting, ground rule.
Ground rule, does he need to set up?
Yeah.
He need to facilitate. Okay. Again, he don't need to set up the ground rule.
So he may propose and finally get set up. So something like the way we want to move forward. So in order to facilitate discussion, is one time one person speaking. Let the other person finish. You will get a time.
Okay.
Something like that.
People discussion on topic. Sometimes it goes.
Okay. So structure the meeting. Promote the sharing. Keep the discussion focused towards the topic. So don't let the discussion go off track. So stay on track. Okay.
Focus on outcomes.
So put a structure for a meeting which defines an outcome and lead people towards that.
Identifying the right set of people required for that meeting.
Okay, so in a good meeting structure, organizing a meeting, we may need to talk about identifying the right people. So first is stakeholders or the participant. So selection of participants is something a key to organize a good meeting, and he should have that skill. Now, why I wrote here is, sometimes you may get invited just as a professional facilitator where people are already there. He says these are 10 people who want to discuss something, can you facilitate? So in that case, you not necessarily is having the stakeholder identification skill, but as a project context, as a project manager, scrum master and all, in order to have a good meeting, you need to have a right people also in order to have that particular meeting. So it's not necessary a facilitation skill, but definitely a project management skill. What else?
When homework done on the topic which is getting discussed.
Okay, now we are getting into a controversial topic. See, now that is what we were looking at. See, as far as facilitation skill is concerned, you need to be neutral. I don't know about subject. I don't need to know about subject. The people who are coming are the one who will know about subject. Now, there are different type of facilitation, because facilitation word has been used very differently. It could be a facilitated training. When I am doing a facilitated training, then it means I am facilitating, but I am leading the discussion. I am the content authority. If it is a facilitated consulting, then it is I am doing a consulting, so I need to do a homework in that case. And I facilitate the discussion so that people get the message, and I can align my consultation as per facilitation. So you can use that when you are becoming a facilitator consultant. And when you are becoming a pure facilitator, where you are just there and team knows everything about it, then you don't need to do homework. So in a scrum context, in agile context, if you are facilitating a sprint planning meeting, if you are facilitating a sprint retrospective, if you are facilitating any of the crucial meeting, it's not necessary that you know the content. You should be neutral, so that people take it forward. So you are not the content authority, but you are structure authority. Yeah.
Can we get a little deeper into it, or it has to be superficial? Now, if we get into a little deeper, you just said that people know about the topic which is getting discussed, and we are just facilitating in the first moment. There could be two experts sitting, but there is a point of contention or disagreement. Now, how do you identify who is right and wrong over there?
And come out of that.
As a facilitator role, you have to come to an agreement, right?
How then should you do it? Guess.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So, what is the possible way in your view?
Ask.
ask them to write.
But it depends upon the consensus or majority over there. I would play if there are 10 people sitting over there. The majority of the people, I don't know the topic, right?
So you discuss the structure of decision making. You talk about how are we going to decide about the option. Is it based on voting? Is it based on some weighted criteria? That be less, and you don't even know those criteria. You say, if you are making something like a crucial decision about architecture, and you are facilitating a discussion among the team members and system architect to identify the architecture for it. You don't know what it is. But when you are facilitating, initially you may also talk about that what are the key parameters on which we want to rank the alternative architecture. So first facilitation only happens towards how do we rank the candidate things. That's the first thing you do. After that, when you have multiple alternatives, you ask people to vote on it. And if you have some conflict, you also may talk about how are we going to take care of conflicts when we have a really neck-to-neck thing. Because in Agile and Scrum team, you may go for a facilitation which is related to improving the process, which is maybe related to architecture, which might be doing sprint planning and estimation. The planning poker itself is a facilitated exercise. You may not be the right person to do judgment in preparation about it. You could be a one technical guy who may play some role in a sprint planning meeting, I don't know. But rest of the areas, you can't do that. So your best bet is provide a structure so the team can decide. And that's a pure facilitation. But if you are a consultant, and who has come that I am a consultant in this company, and I want to suggest you a scaling framework. That's a one goal, and I am a scaling consultant, I am expert in scaling. In that case, I may drive the discussion. So it is a facilitated consultation. But I am not giving you a direct prescription. I am asking questions, bringing people to it, and I am showing how the safe or less or nexus or something is best for you. That's a different way. It's not pure facilitation. It's not a Scrum Master or Agile Coach. Or in general, again, a person named Agile Coach may be doing consulting also. That's a separate thing. Yeah.
Finalize the conclusion. Is it the responsibility of facilitator, for example, me playing the
role? Providing a structure to finalize a conclusion is a responsibility of facilitator. Now, how it is, he may decide. Yes, say, assuming this discussion, he may decide that, guys, we are starting up a meeting which will lead us to find out a one-day outing place. Now, can we list down the criteria on which we will rank the various options? Okay, he may also set up what is the goal, and can we talk about what is the goal of this meeting? Goal of meeting is definitely a little bit of fun, but primary goal is, say, maybe team building or stressing out or something.
Socialization
thing. So you talk about the goal and says, let's figure out a few criteria which can help us to rank the option. He did that. After that, when the option comes in, he may tell, okay, let us give the ranking, voting, as per those criteria. And as per the vote, he suggests, we will decide based on the votes. Now, this is what? This is structure. And this structure is introduced in the beginning itself. So people don't feel it's a biased one, and later on he thought about it. So that is your goal. You put a structure so the decision can be made. But decision should, it's not necessary to be made by you. If you are making the decision, you are not only a facilitator, then you are a decision-making authority. You are becoming a leader, you are becoming a manager, you have become something. Again, that role may be needed in some context, but that role is not a facilitator. So we are not saying that's wrong, maybe in some context needed, but not.